Despite recent rain, Whangarei put on a sunny day for round four of the New Zealand Rally Champs as Neil Allport and Joe McAndrew prepared for battle.
We're back on a blind rally here, so that makes a difference as well. Sure, our car is much better now than it was at the beginning of the season, so I suppose we'll have to wait and see how it goes here.
We're hoping we can just keep it in the middle of the road and have a fast, clean run, basically. Keep up with Neil, a few marks to follow for the first stages and see how it goes from there.
The rally started with a short publicity stage in Whangarei, and McAndrew looked smooth and relaxed, hoping that he would have the championship sewn up by the day's end. Brian Watkins' Group N Subaru would also suit Northland's fast roads, and he'd need a good result to stay in touch with the Group N Championship. A touch of exotic added to the field with Greg Taylor's X-Works Group N Lancia, which was campaigned by Michael Sundstrom in the Rally of New Zealand. Ross Meekings was another driver who'd need a good result in Group N, which is becoming a fiercely competitive class in New Zealand rallying. But it was Neil Allport in the main freight Mazda who was charging to an early lead. Public roads like this made up the majority of the rally. Their hard base and fine gravel make perfect conditions for the Group A cars to use their 300 plus brake horsepower. Ross Meekings' Group N Celica has a lot less horsepower, and he has to work hard to wrench out maximum speed. Greg Graham has crashed out of the last three rallies, so he was aiming to keep the car on the road and maybe a top 10 finish. Currently leading the national championship, Will Orr has driven steadily all season to gather his points. Barry Sexton tried too hard to keep up with the leaders, but luckily the damage was only to the bodywork, while the surprise results were coming from Chris Joblin and Kim Austin, who were trading places with McAndrew for second and third. Rear-wheel drive club cars are still competitive on these Northland roads, and Vanessa Slee was putting up better times than many of the four-wheel drives. And no one looks as good in the North as Ian Atwood in his 1600 BDA Escort. By stage four, McAndrew has settled into second place. Allport is going for the doctor out in front. Joblin and Austin are snapping at the Group A cars back in third place. But stage five, the longest stage, takes the rally north of Dargaville, and Ross Meekings is only 400 metres into the stage when a tricky corner catches him. Then a bridge has co-driver Colin Smith's name on it. Ouch! Finally, the radiator cries enough, and Meekings backs off to get to the finish. But worse luck for McAndrew. The front suspension is ripped out by a bank. They had to reverse down this road to the finish. 100 metres before the end, the car went off the road, had to be lifted back by spectators. They crawled out of the stage with a minute to spare before exclusion. the rally belonged to Allport if he could finish.
The roads are much drier than I thought they would be, considering the amount of rain, and actually quite hard on the tyres. You know, we are wearing the tyres out quite badly, running out of grip towards the end of some of the longer stages, which I think has probably contributed to Joe's misfortune. But, it's the same for everybody, and, we just have to keep plodding on with it.
Greg Graham was happy to be in the top 10 at the lunch break.
I'm just going to try and gather a bit more experience, a bit more courage, and try and get back to the form that I used to be, and hopefully get a little bit quicker and try and catch up with the likes of Brian Watkin. He's going a lot quicker than me at the moment. I'd like to see if I could catch up with him later on.
Both Watkin and Orr, in their Subarus, were staying in touch, letting the battle up front take its toll and hoping to be in the points at the finish.
It's pretty tight today. It's sort of been stage for stage, and we're having a real good fight. It's good fun.
I had a bit of a moment in the second stage and buffed a post, but apart from that, we're going quite well.
That explains the dent in the back of the car, does it, Will?
Yeah, it's a bit of a nasty one, but we're still measuring. That's the main thing.
Austin and Joblin had been joined by local driver Rhys Jones in the battle for second place, showing that these Group N cars can be competitive and fast, and giving the driver the top results that they have worked for all season. Panoramic views like these were treating spectators as Allport really wound up the Mazda. Leading two-wheel drive Charlie Evans was also giving Mazda fans a treat. And Jones' second place was looking better and better. Meeking's efforts to stay in touch were being plagued by overheating.
We have an overheating problem. We're not really sure what it is, but about 6 to 8 k's into every stage, it starts to climb up the temperature gauge, and we got no choice but to back off. So those two long stages, we went through in half throttle, and we're dropping down the field. But we've seen a bit of action. There's been a few guys off and spinning in front of us and stuck, and Joe McAndrew had a wheel off, so bad luck to those guys.
Ian Atwood was still treating the crowd, and they loved it. Giant killer Dave Strong was on his way to the top 10, closely followed by McAndrew's battered car.
We broke the front suspension arm after blowing a nudge in the bank. Thought we were just going to glance off it, but bad luck, and we had to reverse out of the stage because they'd lost the whole wheel, basically. We're still going, we're blowing, driving as hard, we've won a few stages, we're still going good.
Also in service, Kim Austin, holding third place, if the Nissan would stay cool.
We started the day real well, but after about the third stage, we went head gaskets on the way up. We haven't done nothing to the car since the International. It's gone all season on the same engine, and we've got a feeling that the head gasket's going to go. We'll go hard, and I'll just watch the temperature gauge. As it creeps up, I've got this little trick thing on the computer, the same as Neil's, and we can actually turn the boost down about 10 pounds while we're driving along on the car without getting out.
So I take it it's not a Group N car then, Kim?
No, it's not. It's sort of a Group N and a half.
McAndrew was down but not out. He'd posted the top three stage times from stage 8 to the end, enough to creep into the national championship points and keep his hopes alive for Manawa 2 in 3 weeks. So first overall to Allport, followed by Jones, his best result so far. Third to Chris Joblin after Austin retired. And fourth place to Will Orr, keeps him in front of the national championship.